going on, YouTube friends? What's going on with my Patreon friends? How we all doing? Day is it Sunday? It's snowing like hell outside, man. Like, what is going on out there? Nasty. All my Southern Alberta friends, man, I hope y'all staying safe. Anyone else being hit by weather, any kind, man, I hope y'all staying warm. I'm so cold. I've been so cold all day. Try to do some of these reactions, get into my day here. So my friend JG on Patreon sent me this one. This is Chloe and Holly perform Don't Make It Harder on Me live on the Honda stage. Looking forward to this one, man. These two have been like really, really bringing the heat the last little while. All the ones that I've watched, man, have been like just rock and roll, like serving dope vocals. Lots to talk about. I'm not gonna spend my time doing it here. If y'all also want to send me your links or check me out on Patreon, the link's in the description box. I greatly appreciate that. You can like and subscribe here on YouTube as well. It's the best way to support the YouTube channel. That and the thumbs up on the video. Help a boy out. It would help a boy out, man. Let me tell you. Let's get this started.
Already had your chance, so I need you to stop saying the things you say. I don't want to regret now the reason I didn't stay. If you keep
acting, I'm gonna start this whole thing over again. Let's go back 36 seconds. No problem. Listen to this. I like how it's like still vibrato. Like it's just like the control, and it sounds like they're letting a lot of breath out. Like normally I would point out things like compression where they're like holding back the airflow, but it sounds like they're letting more air out than like, you know, you would expect for the note. And it starts to get like almost breathy sounding, right? It's fantastic control.
Already had your chance, so I need you to stop saying the things you say. I don't want to regret now the reason I didn't stay. If you keep acting so sweet, I might just wake up and leave this boy that I pinky swore we'd be together for sure. I can't.
Wow, man, like I'm going to listen to this whole chorus again here, but like, so I was really liking from like a songwriter perspective that when they're doing the harmonies and then, Chloe goes up for the high part and then it's like up into the register where the harmony was. So it's like the two play back to get back and forward so well. And it plays into their capacity to be able to do this unison stuff and make it sound like it's almost one voice. I just watched an interview of the Clark sisters talking about that, how, you know, they wanted one voice or three voices to sound like one voice. It's just like, what a talent, man. What a talent. What a gift. And like, what a discipline that must be, you know? So lost. I don't know who's singing one part. it's just amazing. Like how, like I say, like the notes play back and forward with each other. They're almost like, if I didn't know better, I'd say they're almost like rounds, but it's definitely like a call and answer, but from notes and pitches instead of words. And then like, I don't know if anyone's singing the low harmony, if that's like a backing track or something they pre-recorded. I don't know if they're both still singing in unison at the top. I have no idea what's going on, bro. This is wild. Okay, I think Chloe's doing the low harmony. I think.
Never did. Why did we stop being together now?
just so easy, eh? It's just so smooth and buttery, and it's just like that whole section just looked like a walk in the park. So now there's like obvious separation, right? So that's cool. That's cool. It's good to hear because I was getting so lost before. Oh my God, what did I do? Man, it's like ad-libs that are harmonizing with each other too. Like, it's just stunning. It's just stunning. And then like back to the conversation about like sounding like one voice. It's like they're each doing their own walks, but when they sing in harmony, it sounds again like sonically to me it sounds perfect. Like it's perfectly matched. It's just like what a stunning show, man, of like two singers. And like, okay, so I'm going to nerd out about these microphones for a second. The Sennheiser mics are really cool. They're really beautiful. They sound really, really nice, especially for artists that are involved and they want to go out into the room and listen to like what the mix sounds like with the band or with like the backing track, whatever's going on. Apparently they just like respond really well with PA systems like that. But what I'm appreciating is that they both have very good mic technique and they both have the mic positioned differently. So one is kind of like upright and one is more like square too. But nonetheless, they're not leaving the proximity of the mic capsule. So like you'll see a lot of singers say if it's upright and now they're talking into the microphone this way, it's just, and it doesn't sound the same. My compressor might help because I got like stuff to help that a little bit. But like, you know, from a performance standpoint, you don't want that, right? You want to stay in the proximity that the mic wants. If anything, you want to get close to it and then just like an inch away, right? So it's really good to see that, you know, they both are either like choosing, like they just like having their microphone like that and they're still staying true to the pattern, or they're just like aware enough that doesn't matter where the microphone is, they're going to have good mic technique, right? So I love it. I love it. Fun now. Wow. Great song. Great song too. Great song too. This is the ad. Okay, I'll let the video end. Fantastic though, man. I thought it was great. I thought it was a fantastic performance. I thought it was a dope showcase of like what I'm interpreting to be, you know, trying like playing off the voices and like kind of the magic of the matching while still having like their own tone, their own swag, like their own verses, separating the verses and like being able to showcase not only just like poetry and like the lyrical side of songwriting, but like the melodies too, and playing off each other and probably writing in the same room and showing that like they're a gifted duo, you know what I mean? And like, I appreciate them both as solo artists and I appreciate them just as much together, and this is a great celebration of that, I think. So my friends, Jay, I appreciate the love, appreciate the requests. See y'all again soon.